What's up, Grio fam? I'm your host, Nayo Campbell, and welcome to TheGrio Top 3, where we count down the top 3 trending stories of the day. And coming in at number 3, Alfonso Ribeiro, who most of us know as Carlton, opens up about feeling rejected by the Black community. Ribeiro has always expressed his gratitude for the show's success, but he has also been vocal about being typecast as characters like Carlton. He says, "It still happens almost every day, unfortunately. I'm in a mixed relationship and I get things and looks and comments constantly. And I find it very interesting because you see a lot of things on social media where people say things and people have positions and perspectives. And it's not easy to make that choice because you're not at home in any home. I'm never going to be white and I'm never going to be fully supported in the Black house." He mentioned that he doesn't feel fully supported by the Black community and even said that he doesn't get invited to the BET Awards. Now, of course, this might seem super small, and he said that he could always, you know, just purchase a ticket, but it's just crazy the fact that he doesn't get invited despite being on the well-known show like Fresh Prince and hosting a show, America's Funniest Home Videos. Now, of course, Black Twitter had some things to say, but what are your thoughts? Up next at number 2, repercussions are still coming for DaBaby for his homophobic comments at Rolling Loud. The next thing that was canceled for DaBaby was his performance at Lollapalooza. Yes, DaBaby was set to be one of the closing acts at Lollapalooza, but they released a statement saying that he was cut from the closing lineup following his crude and homophobic remarks he made last week at the festival. The festival tweeted this: "Lollapalooza was founded on diversity, inclusivity, respect, and love. With that in mind, DaBaby will no longer be performing at Grant Park tonight." The organizers also tweeted that the rapper Young Thug would be performing at 9 p.m. instead of DaBaby. DaBaby's label has not released a comment on the cancellation. And for number 1, we have Dolly Parton revealed she used Whitney Houston's song royalties to support a Black neighborhood. Now, everyone knows the song, "I Will Always Love You," but I'm gonna be honest here, not many know where it actually came from. The song was originally written and performed by Dolly Parton, but you guys know what Whitney did. I mean, Whitney Houston took the song and, well, it became Whitney's song. And Dolly Parton's definitely okay with that. I mean, hello, it's Whitney Houston, I would be too. Well, Dolly Parton opened up in an interview with Andy Cohen, stating that she used her royalty checks from the hit ballad to pour into a Black community. "I bought a property down what was a Black area of town, and it was mostly just Black families and people that lived around there. It was off the beaten path from 16th Avenue, and I thought, well, I'm gonna buy this place, the whole strip mall, and I thought this is the perfect place for me to be." Considering it was because of Whitney, she considered the building the place that Whitney built. Dolly Parton has stated in previous interviews that Whitney did such a fantastic job, and I thought, wow, I wrote that little song. That's when I felt my worth as a songwriter. This is my gift, and I'm gonna do the best I can with it. And you all, honestly, I'm so thankful for Dolly Parton for writing that song, because like I said, it's Whitney. When you think of Whitney, you think of "I Will Always Love You." Ugh. We love you, Whitney, and shout out to Dolly Parton for pouring into this Black neighborhood. All right, you guys, this has been the Grio Top 3. Make sure you guys head over to youtube.com/TheGrio for more videos like this. And also be sure to check out thegrio.com. Thank you all so much for watching.